Okay, touch the glove. Back to the corner.
Look how much the two-time Pancration world champion Kseniya Lachkova towers over the deep jewels featherweight champion Mei Yamaguchi. First round. It is just after 4:30 in the afternoon here in Tokyo.
Ready?
And already the Ryogoku Kokugikan is full. Jab early there from Lachkova. High kick from the Russian. Yamaguchi possesses a beautiful overhand right. And with a tall opponent like Lachkova, well, it's tailor-made for that overhand.
Especially because that overhand right is also going to put her in a perfect position to snatch up a single leg as well. So watch for that. Watch her throw that overhand right, drop down, grab that single, turn into a takedown.
Jab right there from Lachkova. An 80% finishing rate for the Russian on a 5-bout winning streak tonight. Yamaguchi, who twice fired unsuccessfully for the Atomweight World title, both times came agonizingly close to defeating Angela Lee. We'll see Lee later on tonight shooting for the strawweight world title against Zhong Jinan.
Good takedown defense so far from Lachkova. Able to keep that over-under position, back her up against the cage and separate.
No sign of nerves on Kseniya Lachkova this week around the hotel and all the media engagements. Very comfortable, very relaxed. Comes in with a very good reputation. Just a filling out process at the moment here for both Lachkova and Yamaguchi. Jab two there from Lachkova, sitting behind the reach. How does Mei Yamaguchi overcome the height differential here, Mitch?
She's got to get, first of all, she's got to try to get into that range. She's got to try to get into that boxing range first. She can start throwing some of these hands. She's having a hard time dealing with the range of Lachkova, and Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her at bay with that jab and keeping that distance off. Watch the footwork of Lachkova. Every time you can see Mei Yamaguchi trying to close that distance, Lachkova's moving out and throwing that right hand of hers. She's not throwing any kicks either. She's not giving Mei Yamaguchi a chance to catch any kicks, and she's throwing just hands at this point.
Even though we are sold out here at the Ryogoku Kokugikan, very quiet. The Japanese are renowned as the most educated martial arts fans in the world. They sit there, they soak it all in, all the techniques, and their deep appreciation for the martial arts. In what many people believe and call, amongst myself, the spiritual home of the martial arts. And it's great to have one championship here for the very first time. Single leg lock on from Mei Yamaguchi.
Good job by Mei Yamaguchi to get connected here as she approaches that single leg. She was finally able to duck under some of these punches from Lachkova, close that distance, grab onto that single leg. Look how Lachkova's got that overhook on her right side. She's trying to keep the posture nice and high so Mei Yamaguchi's not able to drop down, change levels, and at least try to circle around and get that double leg. There she goes, trying to get that double leg. Now her hands are almost locked. Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her legs separated and also using the overhooks to control the posture of Yamaguchi and not enable her to drop down and lock those hands together. Good defense, technically, from Lachkova.
Big hello to all of our Japanese viewers watching tonight on TV Tokyo and Abema TV. Championship, the very first time in Japan. Turn around here from Lachkova, backs Yamaguchi against the fence, crossing elbow from the Russian. Now it's Yamaguchi's turn, nicely done from Vivi.
You can see Yamaguchi has both underhooks. She's got two arms underneath the arms of Lachkova. And Lachkova has such good balance in that reach advantage, height advantage, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts by Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi has to keep her back pressed up against the cage there, or Lachkova would have taken her back. Good job.
And there's the appreciation from the crowd here in Tokyo. Lachkova, who is renowned as a first-round finisher, three-round finishers, has not come out as explosively tonight as we've seen her in the past. But this is her step up to the biggest stage of all, the largest martial arts organization in the world, ONE Championship. And she's handling herself very well, I might say, Mitch.
Yeah, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts, and that is a category of our judges' scoring, is takedown defense. And you can see how she's able to do it. You can see just then, Yamaguchi came in with the overhand right, tried to drop down that single leg, and Lachkova was able to spin her around, press her up against the cage, and now is doing very well inside the clinch.
20 seconds remains. There's the right hand. Now loading it up is Mei Yamaguchi. Traditional martial artist out of Japan against the Pancration World Champion. Takedown there. Final 10 seconds. Yamaguchi on her back. Elbows to the top of the head there from VV Mei Yamaguchi. 1 foot on hips, and that's how the round ends. It's wow. ONE Championship, a new era, live from the Rio Goku Kokugikan in Tokyo, Japan.
Very impressive finish. Look at this, Mei Yamaguchi trying that overhand right. And look at that, she's able to keep her shoulder nice and tight to her chin and was able to deflect a lot of that power coming from Mei. But then, here in the exchange, Mei Yamaguchi lands that short left hand, but Lachkova, the towering kickboxer, was able to throw that overhand right and touch Yamaguchi on the chin. But more significantly, Lachkova was able to score a big takedown at the very end of that round and end the round in a very dominant position. Now, we don't score round by round, but at the first 5 minutes, Lachkova is looking very sharp in all the different areas.
We're ready to roll, second round of three between Kseniya Lachkova and VV Mei Yamaguchi. A magnificent scene inside this incredible building. The Kokugikan, renowned as the Sumo Arena here in Japan. Its hallowed hallways have been walked by some incredible martial arts champions. Tonight, many of them on display, over 130 martial arts world champions in ONE Championship. Yamaguchi comes up firing with the right hand. Inside leg kick, missed the target. Counter there from Lachkova.
This is what Mei Yamaguchi has to do. She has to make this dirty. She can't allow Lachkova to stand at her range and touch her up with those hands. She's got to get close. She's got to make it dirty. Throw that right hand. That's it. Get nice and tight now. How can she do it? She's got to change levels, drop down, tack that single leg. Good defense from Lachkova. The way she's able to utilize these overhooks to control the position of Yamaguchi is very impressive. Yamaguchi's incredibly strong inside the clinch. Again, she's a judo black belt.
Inside leg there, drops down. Locks onto a single leg. Does Yamaguchi, can she affect the takedown? Can she get the Russian on her back? It was Yamaguchi who was on her back at the end of the opening round. As Mitch said, Lachkova doing a lot right so far here tonight.
See, she's utilizing that underhook to keep Mei Yamaguchi posture nice and high and keep her from dropping down. She's even trying to lace these legs and go for the takedown. Lachkova might have grabbed the takedown there. Might have stopped the takedown by grabbing the fence, but eventually Yamaguchi was able to get it.
Close guard from Kseniya Lachkova. 3:20 remains. Second round of three. Throws that close guard up a little higher now, does Lachkova. Let's see if Mei can posture up, break it open, lands it ground and pound. Postures up now, does Mei, the hands are locked up for the moment. Tries to get the right hand free, wants a hammer strike. And again, close guard, opens it, closes it again, does Lachkova.
You can see Lachkova's trying to pin down one of these arms, look for an armbar. Yep, there she goes, throw the hips up. And as we see, this is a big high on the arm. You can see the elbow is almost out. She might be able to pop it out, but she's got to, you know, because of the length of Lachkova, she's able to attack a lot of these positions.
And that predicament is Mei Yamaguchi, still top position here for the Japanese martial artist. Good right hand there for Yamaguchi. Snap back in the schnoz of Lachkova, then goes to the body.
Lachkova's got a very active guard. You can see her. She's always trying to look for something. She's trying to pin down these arms, trying to lock one of those arms into place so she can start throwing those legs up.
Lachkova eats another right hand.
Good job from Mei Yamaguchi to control that top position. Not putting herself in any big danger, but she is starting to land some ground and pound as well.
Where does Lachkova go from here, Dragon?
I'd like to see Lachkova keep attacking his arm, like this. She's trying to pin down that arm like that, and she's going to try to go try to swing one of these legs over and attack another arm bar again. Mei Yamaguchi is not going to make a mistake by putting her hands on the ground and give Lachkova the ability to shoot a triangle. But what we are seeing is I'd like to see Lachkova just separate here, put the feet on the hips of Mei Yamaguchi and start to push her away. But she keeps hunting for that armbar.
Hammer fish there from Yamaguchi from inside the closed guard of Lachkova. Ooh, goes to the bread basket. One up to the chest there from Yamaguchi. Three levels in three punches there from Mei Yamaguchi. 1 minute 15 remains. Little peppering shots on the side of the jaw there from Mei. And Lachkova looks to Clark towards her corner. They're giving her instructions here, the Russian.
Lachkova's looking for the finish. She's trying to throw those legs up. See how high her guard is? She's looking for this, but Mei Yamaguchi's not making really any mistakes to give Lachkova the opportunity to throw that submission in.
Mei Yamaguchi, one of six Japanese competitors on tonight's card. Can she give Team Japan a great start here inside the Rio Goku Koku Gikan for ONE Championship, a new era? Hiroki Akimoto up next, Senzo Akeda later on. Of course, Ken Hasegawa still coming. So Yuya Wakamatsu against Demetrius Johnson. Big lineup, big night for Japan. Two punches, then one to the bread basket from Mei Yamaguchi. We do have another Russian on the card too later on, in the form of Timofey Nastukin taking on Eddie Alvarez. Don't sleep on Nastukin. When he goes beast mode, Eddie Alvarez had better keep his hands up.
Good ground and pound coming from Mei Yamaguchi. Very calculated strategy here on the ground. She's picking her shots, and she's doing just enough work to stop the stand-up from Kemp Chang. Here's that takedown that she was finally able to get. Beautiful double leg as she's able to turn off the cage and push Lachkova on the back.
And wherever you're watching around the world, it is the biggest card in history. ONE Championship, a new era. In Tokyo, Japan, third and final round here between Mei Yamaguchi and Kseniya Lachkova. How do you see it so far, Trevor?
That's pretty close at this point. There was a lot of effective ground and pound coming from Yamaguchi. I think at this point, it's gotta come down to these last 5 minutes on who can turn it up the most and clinch this victory in one of the biggest cards in history.
Jab two there from Lachkova. Seemed to be a bit more gusto from Yamaguchi coming out of her corner. Can she get on the inside of the reach of Lachkova? Maybe find range with that overhand right. There it is. Just caught the shoulder though, the lead shoulder of the Russian.
See, watch how Lachkova's stance is. She's always bringing her left shoulder nice and close to her chin, and that's been able to deflect a lot of the shots from Yamaguchi.
Completely different builds between these two martial artists. Counter right hand there from Yamaguchi, throws the right down the corridor again.
And that right hand was able to connect because Lachkova switched to southpaw and it opened her up for that shot.
Yamaguchi wants to drop down, see if she can take Lachkova onto her back. Move right down the chair. Once more there from Yamaguchi. Crowd response to it. Now starting to find range with the right hand. There's a double leg from Yamaguchi and a takedown. I love it. Inside the Rio Goku Koku Gikan.
Now Yamaguchi's starting to feel the moment, and she's realizing that this is still her match to get. And she's able to do a lot of good work here in the third round.
Yamaguchi.
Beautiful right hands landed by Yamaguchi.
Top position here. As she ended out the previous round, a little hammer fist there from Yamaguchi. Knocking down the wrists is Lachkova. Another one there to the orbital. 3 minutes and five remains. Third and final round, Russia versus Japan, as Lachkova tries to lock on for an arm.
Triangle. There it is. For the Russian. Finally able to get it. She was looking for it the entire time, but it looks like Yamaguchi is able to use Lachkova's attempt at a triangle to get the pass and now sits inside side control.
Able to shot the head. And this crowd sold out already here in San Rio Goku Koku Gigan is loving it every time Yamaguchi lands.
Man, typically, Michael, the Japanese crowds are so quiet, but even their sense of the moment, the magnitude of this card, and they're getting into it.
Since this card was announced, I believe it was last October, the buzz has been incredible. And over the last week, it has reached fever pitch here in Tokyo.
Nice ground and pound still coming from BV, Mei Yamaguchi. Now she's sitting in half guard, and Lachkova's got to do something to get back up. She's got about 2 minutes to work. Yamaguchi's got heavy top pressure at this point. Now she's trying to pin her left leg on the thigh of Lachkova, and what she's going to try to do is try to slide her right leg through the half guard just like that and sit into mount and take the back possibly here of Lachkova looking for armbar.
Armbar from BV by Yamaguchi. Is she going to tap her out? In the third and final round. Yes, she does. It's a win for Yamaguchi. It's a win for Japan. It's an historic win. Yamaguchi brings the house down in the Rio Goku Kokugika.
Wow, that was beautiful. Mei Yamaguchi was able to find the finish. It didn't happen in the first, but it eventually happened in the third. Beautiful finish, submission victory for VV Mei Yamaguchi in her hometown of Tokyo, Japan. Inside the guard. Look at this. Ducks under the punches coming from Lachkova. Chases down the double leg. And then she was able to slide through the guard. There she is landing a big knee to soften Lachkova up. Inside control. She passed into mount. You can see Lachkova extending the arms, gift wrapping the arm bar. Mei Yamaguchi takes it home like Christmas and gets the finish. Look at this adjustment. There's the thumb. Watch the thumb. The thumb has to stay up. There's no place for Lachkova to go except to tap her way out. Beautiful win from Mei Yamaguchi.
Let's go to Tom Lounge to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 18 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of armbar, Mei Yamaguchi!
There are six Japanese warriors on tonight's card. Yamaguchi is the first, Aoki will be the final, and it's one from one for Team Japan in Tokyo.